In the early morning hours of September 10th of 2022, a new volcanic eruption began at a shallow submarine volcano in Tonga. This new eruption was not occurring at the now infamous Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai volcano, which was obliterated in the planet's largest explosive eruption in 31 years earlier this year, but rather at a different volcano known as Home Reef. Before the eruption began, this volcano, whose edifice began at a depth of 1,100 meters below sea level, had a summit at a mere 10 meters or 33 feet below sea level. The reason it was so shallow was because this volcano has twice formed a temporary volcanic island, rising above sea level in both 1984 and 2006. Because of this, it took less than 12 hours of erupting for Home Reef to once again climb above the ocean's surface, forming what at the time was measured by Tonga Geological Services to be an island 70 meters wide and with a summit 10 meters above sea level. While the two previous eruptions, whose lengths are measured, only lasted 5 and 10 days, this eruption is now in its 15th day. And, strangely, unlike the two prior eruptions, it appears to be unusually non-explosive. During this time, the new island of Home Reef has grown from 70 meters to 170 meters to 182 meters wide, and now the most recent measurement is 218 meters wide. While this new island is growing at a rate which is slower than prior eruptions, which formed temporary islands up to 1,500 meters wide, something is quite different. While prior eruptions built islands primarily out of ash, although it has not been completely confirmed, it appears that this newest island is instead being built out of viscous dacite lava. Using satellite imagery from the Tonga Geological Services, which is a bit higher resolution than the NASA imagery being shown here, you can see what appear to be individual flows of viscous lava. Thus, while Home Reef does produce lava which has the potential to produce a far more explosive eruption than that produced at Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai, there is clearly another factor in play. I speculate that Home Reef's eruptions produced lava that has a lower amount of volatile gases than seen at Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai. While prior eruptions from this volcano have resulted in towering plumes of volcanic material which reach above 10 kilometers in height, the plume during this eruption has regularly been under 2,000 meters in height. Using this information, we can estimate the volcanic explosivity index reading of the ongoing eruption. Based on comparing it to typical eruption plume heights, the ongoing eruption seems to best fit a volcanic explosivity index rating of a 1 or a low 2. While prior eruptions from this volcano were explosive throughout the entire length of the eruption, the ongoing eruption did not produce any amount of measurable ash until its 11th day. In total, while the volcano has produced more than 70 total individual eruptions since September 10th, only two of them produced quantities of ash. This is a bit exciting, as it further infers that the newest island contains a substantial volume of lava rather than ash. While volcanic ash islands, such as those produced from Sete Cidades in 1811, Home Reef in 1984 and 2006, or Fukutuku Okanoba in 2021 tend to wash away quite quickly, typically within 2 years, lava-rich islands tend to remain for decades, if not longer. This is the reason why the expanded island created by the Nishinoshima volcano has remained, as you can see by the abundance of more erosion-resistant lava it created. In other words, if the Home Reef volcano truly is producing a lava-rich, mainly effusive eruption, there is a good chance that we might have the world's newest semi-permanent volcanic island. I want to note that prior eruptions of this volcano have distributed explosively erupted rafts of pumice to the shores of Fiji and Australia. However, I have yet to see evidence of any similarly large rafts from the ongoing eruption. Regardless, the Tonga Geological Services have ordered all ships to stay at least 4 kilometers away from the ongoing eruption. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Gordon Bentley, for supporting this channel.